Hey, it's Dan Phoenix here. So I'm excited to share with you a book that I'd highly recommend that anyone gets. And I believe everyone needs to be having this book. So the book I'm going to be talking and reviewing is this book called Sacred Cow, The Case for Better Meat. And as it says on the front, well-raised meat is good for you and the planet, unlike what a lot of people believe. And I'm not sure how I'm going to structure this video in any way, shape or form, because I've never done a video like this before, but I'll do my best to share my own personal opinion on this book. So this is a book that is a newly released book. I pre-ordered it months ago from America. It just arrived in Thailand the other week. I've almost got to the end of the book, but because I am just so excited about this book and the information in it is just so amazing, I was only going to make a video on this book once I finished it. But yeah, like I said, I need to share it with you at this point because it is definitely one of the best books that I have ever read. And I have read so many different books on so many different subjects, but this one is by far one of the best books that I have ever read. And no, I have not been paid to make this video whatsoever. I actually searched up. No one else has done a review on this book yet on YouTube, so I'm the first person to do it. And this book was created by Diana Rodgers and Robb Wolf, which you may know of them or not. And yeah, I'm just going to read out the first thing at the top that was said by Mark Hyman, MD of Cleveland Clinic Center for Functional Medicine. The answer to our broken food system is not no meat, it's better meat. If you're concerned about red meat's impact on your health and the planet, this book is for you. And he's exactly right. This book is for those type of people. So if you're someone that cares about your health, the environment, the animals, then this book is by far one of the best books on these different subjects. And what I'm going to do is, so you can get a rough idea on what this book is all about, I'm not going to read out things from the book. I'm going to read some things out on the back of people that have done a review later on in the video, and I will give you a rough idea of the contents of this book by reading out the different chapters. So first off, chapter one, meat as a scapegoat, which so many people that are ex-vegans will know about this and what this means. And then part one, the nutritional case for better meat. Are humans omnivores? Are we eating too much meat? Does meat cause chronic disease? Is meat a healthy food? Well, vegans will tell you they're not. Well, that meat is not, but yeah, they've just got a lot of dogmatic beliefs and opinions that are very idealistic and untrue that they push on people left, right and center. Even if meat isn't bad for me, can I get all of my nutrition from plant skins? Vegans will tell you that you can, but not true. And part two, the environmental case of better meat. What role does livestock play in our environment? Which is a very important part in this book. The environmental aspects, I think, are definitely the most important parts, at least for me personally. And can a sustainable food system exist without animals? Are cattle contributing to climate change? Aren't cattle inefficient with feed? Don't cattle take up too much land and too much water? The vegans were trying to get you to believe this, but as you'll find in this book, that is actually based on very good science. A lot of those things that vegans preach left, right, and center are not true whatsoever. It's just them trying to push their vegan agenda. And in part three, the ethical case for better meat. Is eating animals immoral? Why did meat become taboo? Why eat animals if we could only survive on plants? And then the last part of the book is what we can do. And under that is feeding the world and eating like a nutrivore. So the reason why I love this book is because it just covers every different aspect as to why meat is good for us, the planet and the animals. So they're covering everything. It's a very holistic book, so to speak. And the brilliant thing about this book is the people that created this book are so knowledgeable on what they're talking about in this book. So it's not based on ideologies or theories. It's actually based on very, very good science, as I've mentioned earlier on. And what this book will do is going to be different for many different people. If you're someone that's not aware that red meat isn't good for you, this book's going to make you aware that red meat is actually one of the most nutrient-rich and best food sources that you could have within your diet. And it doesn't cause things like heart disease and diabetes and many different health issues, unlike what a lot of doctors out there that will tell you, that tell you that actually red meat's not good for you and you need to be eating a lot less red meat. So if you're someone that's concerned around eating meat and you think red meat is not good for your health, well, this is going to dismay any fear or concerns that you have around this. And then the environmental stuff that they share. Like, I knew a lot on the environmental impact of pasture-raised animals, more specifically cows, because they are not promoting factory-farmed animal food sources whatsoever and factory-farmed meat. They're all about pasture-raised animal food sources because it has actually been proven to lower greenhouse gas emissions, improve the soil, because we have a massive issue, especially in the agriculture industry, with monocrops and depleted soil, and then the runoff from the pesticides in to rivers and lakes and seas, and just all of the environment being destroyed for these monocrops to be grown. So yeah, they're very, very conscious around the animal food sources and what they're talking about in this diet, because they only want to promote farming methods of animals that are sustainable and that are actually regenerative for our environment and the land and the soil. So this is a very unique book. I'm sure there's some other books that talk about this, but not to the extent that they do in this book. It is just a real, real eye-opener. And if you're someone that is newly off of a vegan diet, because I quit a vegan diet myself last year, I was on a vegan diet for around 6 years. If you want to know why I quit, click link for the video up above where I talk about it in more detail. But if you're someone that's maybe feeling bad about eating animals, you still believe that it's not good for your health, it's not good for the environment, this book will just get off those vegan goggles that you've had on for a long time and get you to realize, well, actually it's not true. All the vegan brainwashing and dogma that you had been programmed from these vegan preachers and scientists and teachers and doctors and so on, it's just not true in any way, shape or form. So you can actually start to feel good about your food choices with eating pasture-raised meat, if that's what you decide to do. And yeah, this book, I just can't explain it and give it the best review possible, because there's just so much information in this book. What I'm saying is just a short snippet of what you're going to find in this book. And it actually says in here that there's a sacred cow documentary film. I just noticed that now. I have to check that out. So yeah, if you're interested in this book, I'll put a link down below for it. I highly recommend that you do get it. Try and buy it for your family members, your friends. And if you have someone that's not thriving on a vegan diet, that's actually got open mind, it might actually be good to show them this book, because it could get them to realize what they're believing is not necessarily true. And then this could help them regain their health, because then they could see, oh, actually it's good for the environment and it's good for our health and all the other different things that will make them start think, oh, actually I could go back to meat and start regaining my health, because the meat is gonna give me certain things that are lacking on a vegan diet that they talk about in this vegan diet, and why a vegan diet isn't sustainable at all and not healthy to eat a 100% plant-based diet. And as I say, this is not an anti-vegan book whatsoever. I think that's really good that they mentioned that. They are not hating on vegans in any way, or even bashing them. They're saying they're good people and they have a good intent, but a lot of what they're saying is not necessarily true and is detrimental and dangerous for people. So I like that they come from a very conscious way with a very non-violent approach when talking about the vegan diet and the plant-based diet. And they do go on to talk about why in things like these fake meat, Impossible Burgers and Beyond Burgers are actually really, really bad for our environment and our health. And actually, they actually use up way more water to produce these foods as well. Unlike what a lot of vegans believe and think, beef actually uses up way more water than it does to make things like these greasy, like, dirty, toxic filled ingredient, plant-based fake meat burgers. So before I end the video, I want to read the back of the book. A few people that did some reviews. So Mark Sisson, who's a New York Times best-selling author of The Keto Diet Reset, a convincing case that eating meat can be done in an ethical manner. I highly recommend sacred cow for anyone who eats it. And there's a PhD person from the Sustainable Agriculture at Iowa State University said, sacred cow is a comprehensive, well-documented treatise that provides us with all the scientific data we need to make informed choices about how to eat will benefit both ourselves and the planet. And yeah, the other people, I'm not gonna name all their names because it's just, I think, a bit pointless and waste a bit of time. The next person said, the current war against meat eaters and livestock farmers promises ethical, ecological, and health benefits from fake lab meat and plant only diets. Sacred cow debunks every utopian promise, with precision and missiles from science and a deep understanding of how life and the planet actually work. And the second to last person said, Diana Rodgers and Robb Wolf fully understand the problems and the solution, which I completely agree. We must change our diets and regenerate our soils, and well-managed grazing animals are critical to this transition. And last but not least, from a PhD professor, abandoning animal agriculture might well be the greatest mistake humanity could ever make. Evidence defending animal-based foods and farm animals as essential for human health and agriculture sustainability is strong, as clearly documented in Sacred Cow. And I could not agree more. And last but not least, they are not dogmatic in this book at all. They're not idealistic. They do share a lot of their own thoughts, as you would with anyone that's creating their own book. That's totally understandable. But like I said, a lot of it is based on science. And as we know, a lot of vegans think they are spreading very good information, comes from a good place, but their scientific studies are very flawed. Unlike the studies in here, where they actually pick apart the vegan studies and actually look at a lot of the vegan studies and what vegans are saying and actually show a lot of what they're saying, they're just focusing on specific aspects in scientific studies. So then it makes it look like eating meat is not good for you and it's not good for the environment, when actually they're just cherry picking certain information from science. So yeah, it's an amazing all round book. And yeah, like I said, if you're interested in it, link down below for it. So any comments or questions, leave them down below. If you've read this book, give your little review down below in the comment section so other people can hear what you have to say on this book. And if you like the video, give us a thumbs up. Please share this with others. And don't forget to click that subscribe button and the bell button next to it. Yes, don't hesitate. I know you are. Make sure that you click that subscribe button and the bell button. Otherwise, you will not be notified of when those new videos are uploaded. And I have new ones coming almost every single day. So as always, stay happy, stay healthy, stay fit, and enjoy the rest of your day. Peace.